Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we're going to learn a concept which is known as your accrued liabilities. Now, what exactly is the accrued liabilities? It is a part of the balance sheet on the liability side. As you can see over here, this is an extract taken so as to make you understand what exactly accrued liability is, where exactly it is located. This is a part of the balance sheet extract of the liability side, and it is a part of the current liabilities. As you can see the details over here, the accrued liability details 1934, and the stored value card liability, current portion of the long-term debt, the total current liabilities, and so on and so forth. But our focus for the day is accrued liabilities. So, we'll start with the first and the foremost thing. What are accrued liabilities? See, accrued liabilities are those expenses that have not yet been paid under the accounts payable. In other words, it can be obligation on the company to pay for goods and services that have been received, but invoices for the have not been yet received. So it exists only on the accrual, you can say, method of accounting. Okay, so they are recorded into the financial statement during, you know, one period and are reversed. They are reversed in the next period. So this will allow the expense incurred in actual to be charged at the accurate price when the payment is made in full. So you can say that the accrued liabilities are the normal periodic payments in nature and are paid in arrears after they are consumed. Like, for instance, a company's water bill is received after the end of the month in which the water is consumed. It is important to record the water expense in the period in which the water is consumed, making relevant accounting entries at the end of the particular accounting period. So, accrual of expense results in the presentation. You can say that of the accrued expense under the relevant accounting heads in the income statement and accrued liability in the balance sheet. Accrued expense in the income statement and accrued liability will go in the balance sheet. Right, now let's understand the example part of the accrued liability. Let's understand the examples. What are the examples? The first one is the accrued interest. Now, interest can be outstanding loan that has been not been paid or billed by the end of the accounting period. That is your accrued interest. Then you have your any accrued payroll. Now, taxes on an employee wages which are due in the next period are the accrued payrolls. The third is the accrued services. Now, services received under the current period but they are not been billed in the next year are the accrued services. The next is the accrued wages. Now, employees earn wages for their services in the current period but are paid in the next reporting period. Then those are the accrued wages. The fifth thing is accrued utilities. Now, utilities are used for your business, but the bill for the same are not yet received. So, these are very small but important differences between the accrued liabilities and the accounts payable. Like, you know, while such liabilities are recorded at the end of each accounting period and involve considerable estimation, and the accounts payable are normally recorded as the normal course of the business based on the proper invoices from the suppliers. Now, this is what I'm going to show you is the accrued liability example of Starbucks. As you can see, the data is for 2017 and 2016. The data, as it is visible, the accrued compensation and related cost, occupancy cost, taxes, dividend payable, and so on and so forth, with the details out there. So, the list of the example in the Starbucks, that is the compensation part, cost part, taxes, or dividend payable, or any capital or other operating expenditure, and so on and so forth. we need to understand the journal entry part. See, the expense will be debited to record the accrued expense in the income statement, and corresponding payable is created on the liability side of the balance sheet. So the accounting entry will therefore be something like this. The expense, that is which will be the part of the income statement, will be debited, and the credit will be given to the expense payable, that is on the balance sheet part, and the same will be credit. The credit will be given to them. Okay, so the accrued liability journal entry step 1 will be when the expense is incurred. So organization incurs the expense in particular accounting period and own a debit but have not yet been billed. So we need to make a record of this expense as an accrued liability in the books of accounts. We need to debit the expense account, and the debit entry will increase the expense. So we need to create an accrued liability expense account on credit with the same amount, and it will increase our liability. So this will be the step 1, that will be the journal entry part. Okay, now the step 2, when the payment is made. So in the next accounting period, when the payment is made, you need to reverse the original entry which has been passed before in the books of accounts. So to reverse the transaction, debit is given to the accrued liability. Debit is given to the accrued liability account, and the debit will also decrease the liability and credit cash or bank account because you paid the expense in cash. It will look something like this in terms of journal entry. Your expense payable, which was previously credit, will now become debit, and the amount that you will pay will go credit. So this will be debited and this will be credited. Let's try and understand the importance part of the accrued liabilities. See, when a company prepares a financial statement using accrual accounting, the financial statements which have been prepared are more accurate, as it is, you know, complete measure of the transaction and events for each period. So this complete picture helps the analyst to better understand a company's present financial statement or the financial health, you can say, and predicts its future financial position in a better way. So this is unlike the cash basis method of accounting, which only records the financial transactions and events when the cash has actually been exchanged, so resulting in the understatement or you can say the overstatement of the income and the account balances. Okay, now before we get into this, we'll take one example on the journal entry. That will be a quick one. See, let's say, you know, a business has an annual building rent standing at 12,000. An invoice has been received from the owner, and thus the rental expense have not been actually been recorded in the accounting books. There are some key assumptions, like, you know, the period which is for, it is going to be, then we have the annual rent which is standing at 12,000. Let's say the accounting period is for 1 month, and there are some accrued expenses which are per period, which will be 12,000 into 1 by 12, which is going to be 1,000. Right, so the journal entry will be, at the initial will be rent expense account, that will be debited to 1,000 to the accrued expenses, which will be standing at 1,000 on the credit side. Right, so the accrued liability on the journal entry shown in this fashion over here about debits the rent expense account, and that represents the cost of the business of that particular month using the premises, and the credit entry which reflects the liability to pay the supplier, owner of the building, for the amount of the service consumed during the period. Now, as per the accounting equation, A is L plus E, that is assets is equal to liability plus equity. So, on the asset side, it will be 0, but on the liability side, there will be accrued liability, which will be standing at 1000, and the rent expense that will go in the owner's equity. This will be the part of the owner's equity, this will be the part of liability, the asset, there will be no impact. This will be 1000 positive, and because it's an expense, so P&L will be negative, so 1000 negative.
If you have learned and, you know, liked the video, if you think that, you know, if you have enjoyed and learned watching this video, please like, comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.